Retirees who rely on interest from their savings are among the biggest losers from last week's Reserve Bank interest rate cut, as term deposit and savings rates are slashed. Experts are urging those considering higher-risk, higher-return investments to exercise caution. But changes to Centrelink rules from July the 1st may offer pensioners some opportunities to improve their cash flow.
For 87-year-old George Ray, falling term deposit rates could cost $40 per week. The pensioner will adjust by economising on food.
You've got to look around for the cheapest stores, which have the cheapest, but sometimes it's not always the high-quality stuff that you'd like to buy.
Even before the Reserve Bank's move, lenders began reducing term deposit rates, some by much more than their later mortgage rate cuts. A couple with $130,000 saved in term deposits could lose some $215 a year.
Really an unfolding slow train wreck that is really cutting a swathe through retirement incomes of very vulnerable Australians.
We have been critical of the banks in the way they've managed some of their financial products and certainly the behaviour in and around the Royal Commission.
One solution is higher risk, higher return investments like shares, managed funds, even property. Though seniors groups say that's not an option for many.
As they get older in retirement, they want to have more security with something like a government-backed term deposit.
CPSA have a pamphlet out regarding term deposits and also the risk against buying shares and that aren't blue chip.
To others taking the risk, this financial advisor says tread carefully when it comes to, say, mortgage-backed securities.
We've seen like Basis Capital, Australian Capital Reserve. Years ago we saw a state mortgage. They all collapsed, you know, and people were enticed into those products with, the sweetener of higher interest rates.
He and lobby groups cautiously welcome forthcoming Centrelink changes. The pension loan scheme, securing loans against the value of the home, has been expanded to include self-funded retirees as well as pensioners.
What you're doing with that is you're accessing the equity in your home earlier to provide you with the income to live off.
Also from July the 1st, pensioners can earn $300 per fortnight, up from $250 without affecting their pension. George Ray, who retired 19 years ago, hopes the government will quickly lower the deeming rates used to assess a pensioner's investment income.
The highest deeming rate is 3.25%. The average term deposit rate is 2%. There is a huge gap, and people, if they stick with term deposits, will lose more in the pension than they really should.
In the wake of the official interest rate cut, the government has yet to announce changes to deeming rates. Renis Arampayat, SBS World News.